Hello, everyone. Welcome to episode 1 of Dynasty Warriors 5. So I was thinking we're going to be playing Zhang Fei for the first story that we're going to be doing. I feel like he has the... Guan Yu, I feel like, attacks very slowly, but his Mishu is very powerful. So I wasn't sure if I wanted to use him or not. And we don't have Liu Bei yet. Otherwise, I would normally pick Zhao Yun, but I wanted to get a nice little change of pace. And, so I was thinking Zhang
Fei may
have
devotion on our plates and blossoms in our cups.
I really don't care about that.
I'm Zhang Fei, so, during the Yellow Disc.
Yeah, then they got the little briefing they're going to do in the beginning of each story, or beginning of each battle. I haven't played Dynasty Warriors 5 before. I wouldn't say this one's my favorite, but it is definitely one of the better Dynasty Warriors games. I would probably say my favorites are between 4 and 6, honestly, which I know hearing 6, a lot of people will hate on me for. Like 6 is really good.
Let's
bring
these
6
scoundrels down for good.
Was in a way ahead of its time, but then they kind of ruined it in certain places. Like, they definitely dumbed down how much content's actually in the game, which was a terrible thing. The lack of characters, so many characters missing, so many copycats, stuff like that. Like, I feel like they really ruined the game when it came to the amount of content that's in it. Maybe if they had made they didn't do that stupid stuff they did with the Dynasty Warriors 6 on the PS2, where you get the 6 extra story modes, watch out, tell people, all of them get their own story. I feel like if they didn't do that, it would have been received a lot better than it did, because then there would have been much more content. And I feel like that would kind of tone down the lack of it.
Hit me with everything you got!
On the PS2 you get extra characters, but the game runs like 20. It kind of, you get the full experience. So I just feel like it was a really bad idea on their part to do that sort of thing with it. And I feel like that's part of the reason why that game gets such bad reception. But I feel like the game in and of itself is actually really good. Looking past the lack of content compared to its predecessors, it was one of the first games that did flow motion combat. I guess you could call it flow motion combat. Kind of like how Batman Arkham series and stuff like that, they have the flow motion. They did that with the Renbu system, which I think was well done. It could be a little frustrating sometimes, but I mean, all in all, I think it was well done. It could have just been some tweaks, and it would have been probably better. Then you got all the cutscenes that just look fucking gorgeous in the game. And all that sort of thing.
Good luck if you think you can break through our defenses.
Just the way the game looks. PC, oh my god, on PC that game looks amazing. It is actually much
speed is of the
more,
essence. Follow me.
It is actually much more difficult on PC than PS2 or Xbox, because the amount of enemies on screen at a time, just there's so many more enemies, they will slap you left and right. I've been still doing well. It makes it a lot easier to level up too, because of that. It's easier to get KOs so you can get more XP. But again, just that lack of, you're missing 6 stories, story modes in that, and that just really sucks. Especially since some of the best, in my opinion, a couple of the best levels were in the PS2 version. I really thought that Battle of Tong Gate was a great battle on the PS2, and that other one. I don't remember the name of the battle, but it was where you play as Tao Pi fighting against Yuan Shao, trying to turn his sons against each other, which I thought that was a really good battle too.
Destroying it will be a real blow to you.
That's, you know, we get a little off track, well, quite a bit off track. But, I mean, that would be why, like, I personally think 6 is in one of the higher tier levels of health.
Trying to take the base! Stop them!
The game, like, I feel like the things it does right, it does real well, but then it just has quite a few things to do wrong. Which is unfortunate. Because I really like the game.
That was impressive.
And honestly, I prefer 6 over the newer games. Like, 7 was alright. 8 was better than 7 for sure. But, I don't know. I just feel like it was a huge, like, this is part of the, partially the fan base's fault on this half, in my opinion. The amount of characters they're adding to the game.
They fell for it.
Because so many people want these characters. They're like, oh, this character did this and this in his lifetime, blah, blah, blah. He'd be a great character to have. And it's just like, okay, but like, you expect
the
them
enemy
to
formation
add
is
all
crumbling.
That information
forward.
Into the game, like, they're not going to do that.
Won't
That's
take it out
way
fast.
Too much work to add one character and then give him, like, his whole story. Especially with this main characters that they have. You know, it's not like they're back at, like, 40 characters where they can keep giving them more and more story. You know, they can't do that. What are they at? 120 characters by now? Like, that is triple of what's in this game. And yeah, it's just like I've seen so many people asking for just more characters. Stop asking for more characters. Ask for like just more characters doesn't necessarily mean more content. Especially when they're copying weapons.
Now is our chance. Prepare to attack.
You know, like when you can select the weapon you want a character to use.
Speed is of the essence. Follow me.
Like, yeah, sure, that's cool for people who want to use specific characters, but like, you end up reusing the same combos, the same way people complained that 6 did. Like, it just doesn't make a whole lot of sense. Now, I do like the weapon switch system, kind of. I don't like how some weapons have the advantage of others, but I do like the idea of being able to switch a weapon mid-battle to a different style. I think that's really cool. And then 9 just kind of straight dog shit. And then, I mean, it's not absolutely horrible, but like, I don't know. I wouldn't put 9 above any of the others. Even like number 2. Like number 2, I still felt like it was entertaining. Maybe that level of challenge. I just feel like it doesn't really have much of a challenge to it. But I do like the. I just feel like they didn't do a great job with what they were trying to do, you know? Like,
retreat is an acceptable strategy.
I think it could be good,
another one down.
But they need to put more content into the world. Maybe, like, better random encounters, maybe. Better, you know, I don't know. They could have done a different engine, I think. A different game engine. Like, I can't say what exactly. Better game engine. Just to change what you do in the game. Like, you know, interacting with NPCs, being able to interact with items, you know, more than the way they do it in that game. I know you can't interact with items, but, like, the way you do it is not the way I'm imagining it in my head. Like, the way I'm imagining interacting with items more like Skyrim in a sense, but obviously putting Skyrim into place. But that's not what I mean. But like, you know, just giving that level of interactivity into an open world, you know, like, you know, because that gives it so much more life to be able to let you interact with things. Like at the very least, to keep into the Dynasty Warriors, theme. Like, just put destructible items in the world that you can destroy, and doing so gives you different abilities, different reputations, like stuff like that. Reputation system would be great.
That's another one down.
You know, like you could raid villages and attack peasants. Maybe not like actual like peasants, like you know some form of militia maybe, as opposed to just murdering innocents. you know, attacking militia and stuff like that to raid the village. You know, that'd be, I think that would have been a great addition to Dice Wars 9 if they did something like that. And then I never played Nine Empires. I didn't think it was going to be good. Like, people kept, that was the dumbest thing I saw people requesting, I swear. Nine Empires. I'm like, why would you request Nine Empires when Nine in and of itself is almost like an Empires game? Like, you can literally go around the map conquering, you know, buildings. Like, I don't know. I just, I could see why people wanted it, but, like, coming from Nine, I don't think was a good idea. Like, they should have made a different, I don't know, do what they did with Nine, make the improvements, make the changes, and then do an Empire. So, like, Dice Wars 10 Empires would have been great. I saw the bad reviews coming from out. The second that game came out, it was mostly negative. And those people that probably gave it a bad review asked for it. It's just so weird. I don't know what we can do. This is why I picked Zhang Fei. Oh my god. Look at all these kills. Great. So I have been working on. I have been working on. What's it called? Oh, that's an ally.
Do you think you can stop me?
I've been working on getting my Dice Wars 4 characters back to level 9, so I can do the level 10 weapon videos.
That's another one down.
So far I got Weiyan. Bay, Pang Tong. Wait, no, not Pang Tong, not yet. I'm pretty sure I got like three or four.
Make your way
so
around
far.
And aim for Dong Zhuo.
But yeah, I'm making good progress on that. I mean,
you
there's still a lot more to go, but I'm working on it. And as far as Dynasty Warriors 6 voice gallery goes, that's taken some time, but I finished everyone in Shu.
For now.
Everyone in
That's
other.
Another one down.
Now I'm working on Wei, which I have, I think, half of them done in Wei, and half of them done in Wu as well already. So I think I only have, like, I don't know, like, less than 10 characters left to go. Maybe more, maybe, like, 12 or something like that. But I made a lot of progress on that as well. I found out about using a two-player thing. Just press a second player button on PC, because I've been doing it on PC because it looks so much better, and it sounds clearer. So I've been using the two-player thing for most battles to level up more characters at once. Currently, I think it was Choose Shu. And
good luck if you think you can break through our defenses.
Xia. Who's the other one I'm trying to get? I think I've been doing pretty good on that. And the reason why I want to start at 5 is, first off, I've been wanting to play 5. I haven't played 5 forever, but like there are things about 5 that I do really like. I don't know, maybe part of the reason why I don't like 5 as much as most others do is, first off, as a kid, I played Empires
I would rather
first,
live and redeem
which being a kid playing Empires, I didn't know what
down.
The call I was doing. But, there was that,
now
and,
is the time to show them what we can do.
And, I think I played Warriors Orochi first. So when I stopped playing Warriors Orochi and then I went to this, I just felt like it was such a huge downgrade as a kid. Like, I was expecting it to, I don't know why. I didn't expect it to be such a huge difference. Like, no special attacks for every character, stuff like that. You get those little golden things. Yeah, that's really it. All that does is just let you use your true Mishu. Well, I guess you could say a stronger version of your true Mishu. I'm gonna save it for Zhang. Damn, we almost got five.
I won't
see why they still send videos.
That's another one
great T for T in game. I mean, I'm pretty sure you can say good. I mean, we watch people die all the time in cutscenes. Especially on the newer games. Like, 4 and 5, I think 3. Like, I mean, they show people die. It's like, way too cheesy the way it looks. No blood, no.
Impressive.
No. Like, just. Oh, I'm dying. Retreat is an acceptable like all you get out of them. That's it.
There's another one down.
Yeah, I think after, I think 6 and on, really started, you know, with cutscenes and stuff. I would love to voice act for a game like this. I would do it cheap, too. I mean, knowing the way Koei is,
never.
Especially
all
now.
Advance like, on the enemy!
Fucking not even getting English voice actors. When they do, they get, like, crazy people. Voice actors are so good. I think I would do well as a character. I'm not saying Zhao Yun, but I'm saying like Zhao Yun. Maybe like what's his name? Fuck, I can't say their goddamn names. Xiao Ba. Xiao. Oh my god. Xiao Wan's fucking son. I think I could probably do his voice pretty well. Something like him, maybe.
Now is the time. Show them what we can do.
That's what I can think of. It's possible, I don't know. But I would definitely love the voice act. I would need practice, though.
Silent Trooper! I shall squash you beneath my feet!
This is my bodyguard, get over here. If you would get over here, I would use my rage. What is he doing? Get over here!
I'm through.
Oh, I can't? It won't work? Wow, and he's gonna block it! That's another thing I hated. Like, that is something I really liked about 3. Breaking guards. Oh my god. Just enemies in 4 and 5 just freaking spam guard all the time. Meanwhile, because the way the game plays, 90% of the time, if you block, you'll just get hit by an enemy. Because even if you kill everyone along the way, like, all your allies exactly follow you all the time. So as many moments were not yet to use your armor. Yeah, so I'm thinking after this, I'm probably gonna do another video of the competition call.
Boo, don't let them near me!
Aw, you whiny little bitch. I know he did. Oh my god. Why is he hitting me with his fourth charge attack? Or fifth? Isn't that technically a fourth charge attack? That already is the first level. This dude just about to die. As someone who never uses the first charge attack, I was very disappointed to see that.
That's another one down!
In this game, as opposed to what 4 did. I mean, I never used them. But I appreciate the effort they went into giving them fancy moves, you know. Like Zhang He does that, and then
we have defeated the
grab attack. I did love the victory music in this game. We got one weapon. Go ahead and save. We gotta save after every match. You never know if my stuff will freeze. PS2.
After the
I don't care. So what is it, like anywhere between 4 and 6 battles per character, like per story thing? Well, we got Tiger Eye Amulet, Mounted House, Mounted Horse Defense. Okay. I thought it was the same level. The same weapon. Okay. And it's light, so we can attack fast. As far as monuments go, we'll get that one dude. Alright, guys. I'm going to end the episode here. You know, I guess it's going to depend on how many battles we do, or how long each battle takes, to see how many we do per video. But, yeah, as of right now, we're going to end it here. So be sure to like, comment, and subscribe. I hope y'all enjoyed, and I will see you all in the next one. Bye.